Okay, great. Great.
All right, Murthel Groenhart, thank you for coming on the show. We look forward to your fight coming up this at the end of what 20 what the 24th of February
24th, yeah.
over in Chicago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're looking forward to it, man. How's are you feeling? We're not too far away from the fight. How's everything going?
Oh, great. Everything's going great. I have a good preparation. I'm thrilled, man. I'm ready for 24 in Chicago. I'm ready to kill.
Awesome. Now, can you remember that disappointing loss to Nikki Holskin at Glory at 34? So with this fight, are you planning to get through this fight and hopefully, you know, go back on your next title run?
Yeah, definitely. I'm not looking back, you know.
Yeah.
I was looking forward. So I lost in Denver, but that's okay. You know, I'm still one of the top guys. And
for sure.
This year, I'm still going to prove myself. So I've been through lots of downs, ups and downs. So you know that can only make me stronger. So.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You're ranking the top five, so that's still pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know. So and I'm ready to be the number one. So
yeah,
just a matter of time.
Yeah, for sure.
And you're competing against Dong Chai City of Tonga. He's he's one of the influx of Thai fighters that are coming into Glory. What do you make of him? And what do you make of him as an opponent? Have you seen him before? And what are your thoughts on all these Thai fighters coming in?
Yeah, I never saw him before. It's new, you know, especially a Thai fighter at 77 kilo.
Yeah.
I never heard of a Thai fighter at this weight. So but you know, he's gonna try it. I mean, he got one fight in Glory and he won. Against somebody I don't know, he won on KO, but not an important figure or something.
Mm-hmm.
So and now he's camp think they're ready for me, you know. So I don't think he's ready for me. I think the whole camp is delusional. So I'm gonna show those guys camp that that he facing the predator, you know. So I'm gonna show him big time what it is on my level.
Yeah. Those Thai fighters. What do you think of the Thai fighters? All these coming in.
Yeah.
There's like a few Thai fighters coming in now. What do you make of them coming into kickboxing? You know?
I don't know. They're trying, you know, to try to get. I think you know, more money, because in Thailand is, I think they fight like every weekend, every day or something for a little bit of money.
Yeah.
So and they know that Glory and you know, the bigger show. More payment, so that's why and the Thai fighters are coming in. I think that's why they're coming in, and that's why Glory let them in, so we have more meat, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why Glory does why Glory and let the Thai fighters coming. I don't know, but more meat for us.
Yeah, I think your opponent has a lot of fights under his record. I think he started his first fight when he was like 11 years old, something crazy like that, and now he's fighting you. A top five, fighter in your division. What are your game plan coming in this fight, or how do you see this fight ending?
my game plan is to, I'm gonna put pressure on him. I'm gonna be there from the round number one. I'm not gonna hold back. I'm not gonna hold back. I'm just gonna show him, you know. If he think he's ready for me, I'm gonna show him and why they call me the predator. So I'm gonna show him from the first round.
Yeah,
because I think both of you guys are both orthodox fighters. I think with you though, you're more of a pressure fighter than he is. He fights, you know, range where you come and you do your dirty boxing, and I think you excel as a pressure fighter.
Yeah,
but that's the style of the Thai fighters, you know. They want to compete with the European fighters, but the Thai fighters are like waiting, and they come with a hard punch or a hard kick, you know.
Yeah.
But but we just keep on going. It's like a storm, you know. Just keep on going, fighting, kicking, punching. Mm-hmm. They'll put the pressure on.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So it's a different style.
Right.
So if a Thai fighter, if they can compete with our style, you know, the thing is gonna cost some time, because you know, it's his second time in Glory and different rules, and you know, we'll see how it ends up for the Thai fighters.
Right.
And what do you make of the rest of the division? I know you have Nicky, who lost his title. You have Cedric is holding the title right now. You have Yongolo, who just competed in the welterweight tournament. What do you make of those guys? Because I know you competed against all these guys.
Yeah, like I said, and you know, I'm waiting like a hungry dog, you know. Mm-hmm. Nicky lost his title. I'm gonna give you some predictions about the upcoming fights. Yeah. Nicky lost his title now, and I already knew Yoan Konglo was gonna win the tournament.
Yeah.
So this is how it goes now. Yoan Konglo will win from Cedric Doumbé. You know, ooh, the guy with the big mouth.
Yeah.
And Yoan Konglo will get his belt, but not for long, because a hungry dog is waiting for him, and
ooh,
that's the Murthel. And after, let me see. The first time he will and the defend his title is against me, and I will take it from
him. Ooh, I like it. I like fancy that. Booking. I love it, man.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
Now,
that's how it goes.
Yeah. Well, it's important to always have a plan as far as your next opponent, without overlooking the opponent, obviously. Do you have someone in mind when you win on the 24th? Who to call out?
Who I'm going to call out when I win the title?
Yeah.
Or when you win on February, at the end of February.
Yeah. When you win.
In Chicago.
In Chicago.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who I'm going to call out? I'm going to call out the two guys, Yoan Konglo and Doumbé, you know?
Yeah.
I'm going to call two guys out, and I'm going to say, be ready, you know, forever who got a title.
Yeah.
Be ready, because I'm waiting there like a hungry dog for one guy who got a title, and you're gonna compete a hard time against me. So if you got a title, if Cedric got a title, if Yoan got a title, doesn't matter. I'm waiting for you.
Ooh, I like it. Nice promo.
Yeah.
So you train obviously at Mike's gym, one of the most famous gyms over in Holland and the world almost. You got so many killers going in there yourself. What do you make of like how are you guys preparing for your fight coming up over in your camp right now?
Now, like I said, we got lots of fighters coming in, man. From China, we got fighters from Bulgaria, we got fighters from Italy, we got lots of fighters from England, we got lots of fighters coming in. So for me, it's great, you know, because I got lots of meat I can spar with, I can train with, you know, and for me, it's like, it's like a candy shop, you know, it's great.
Yeah.
Right.
So my preparation is good now. You know, from all these fighters, you know, different styles, you know. So when I'm sparring with this guy, it's a whole different style. When I'm sparring with this guy, it's a whole different style.
Mm.
You know, so I'm used to the different styles.
Right.
You know, I'm not sparring and training only with the same guy.
Yeah.
So I'm used to the different styles. So it's great, man. For me, it's great.
Awesome. You know, and in Europe, you know, kickboxing is pretty popular. You know, it's like one of the biggest sports out there. North America, not so much. And your next fight is going to be obviously in Chicago, in the United States. I think in the United States, kickboxing isn't as popular because people don't know people's stories or the characters, you know, to invest in. Does that bother you in a way where you want kickboxing to be as popular as it is in Europe?
Oh, definitely, definitely. I want it to be as popular as it can be, you know.
Yeah.
Like now it's now it's like UFC is very popular.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But they got big companies behind it, you know, who support the UFC, and I hope one day the kickbox will be as great too, you know, as big too, because we train also very hard for fights, you know, mm-hmm. Very dedicated, and you know, and then step into the ring for a little bit of cash is, you know.
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
You got the youth, big cash, big amounts, you know. So I hope one day it will be just as big as UFC. Yes, yes. Because lots of people love it. Lots of people love it. They love the kickboxing. They love the style. So you know.
Yeah.
You gotta support the guys.
And for the people who don't really know much about your story, how did you get into to combat sports? How did you get into kickboxing? What brought you into kickboxing? Did you play other sports? No, we know. I'm talking.
Yeah, we know.
I'm talking about for like other fans, like the fans who don't know
okay,
you, or
yeah.
like Tell the fans how you got into it.
Because we know how you got into kickboxing as a teenager and you became a K-1 champion.
Yeah, yeah.
So we know your story. But people that maybe be watching our show and maybe don't know about your story.
Yeah, but the first time, you know, in the beginning, I was a plumber, you know?
Oh, wow.
I was a plumber. But the way I got into kickboxing, I was in the grocery store, you know, with friends in the shopping mall with friends, and we were playing soccer, football, you know, and suddenly one big guy came and some guy passed the ball to me, but it came on this guy, you know, big guy with a beard, and he was doing grocery, and he told us, why don't you guys go play somebody else with your ball, because lots of people are shopping here, you know.
Yeah.
And I told the guy, what you talking about, man? We play whatever we want to play, you know. Ooh, yeah. So he gave us a big mouth. I gave him a big mouth back. And he said, listen, if you all got a big mouth, I got a gym nearby. Why don't y'all come with your big mouth to the gym and then show the ball and show yourself, you know. Okay, no problem. We're coming. So I was separating the crew, you know. I was all the guys from the neighborhood, 15 guys.
Wow.
Were coming to the gym. And that guy was Mike, you know. So the guy I had a big mouth was Mike.
Yeah, yeah.
So we were going to the gym, and you know, he told us when we came and put on gloves. You know, he had gloves in the gym, and we were sparring with him. You know, so each one of us, we was trying to beat him, you know, because he had a big mouth. But hey, fuck no, man. This guy, he beat us all, man. Yeah. I remember when I was sparring with him, and I gave him a right punch. He slipped it. So, you know, I came with my back in front of him. So I looked backwards, and I saw this right punch, this big hand, right punch coming after me, you know?
Oh, no.
And literally, I was running to the gym. He was running to the gym. I was like, fuck, hell no.
Yeah, that's crazy.
But,
wow.
Yeah, no, crazy. And since that time, I loved kickboxing. He beat my ass, but he got my respect, you know? And,
right.
And, you know, he beat my ass, and I know he could teach me more because I wanted him to teach me more of these tricks, you know. So I fell in love with the sport only because of that. I didn't know I could bear money from it, you know.
Yeah.
So, also, that's awesome. The rest was kind of a plus point.
And did any of your you brought a lot of people to the gym with you? All your friends. Did they get into the sport, or were you the one that just lasted longer than everybody?
The one was me. Me and my two brothers was the one who was staying, and we trained, and my bigger brother he got some few knockouts, but he didn't love the tents before the fight, you know, so he stopped, and then it was just me and my brother Fernando.
Yeah,
you know, he's doing MMA now. Mm-hmm. He just got his last MMA fight in Beverly Hills.
Yeah,
won a knockout, Fernando Groenhart. And and me, kickboxing.
Awesome.
So me and my brother.
Yeah.
That's also a nice thing. Me and my brother was competing all the time, you know. So he was fighting, then I have to fight because we was competing with each other. Numbers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. With
numbers. So then I had 10 fights. He had 10 fights. Then I had 15. He had 15.
That's funny.
And, yeah, man. And then we came with 85 fights.
Wow.
And then he stopped. Yeah. And then he went to MMA. So now I got my 110 fights, I think.
That's
now.
Crazy. That's crazy. Yeah, now, at some point, do you want to make that transition to mixed martial arts, or are you content with kickboxing only?
I want to do mixed martial arts. I wanted to do
last
year, 2 years ago. Yeah, really. And I did one fight when I was younger, and I won on points. But when I look at the guys, you know, and when I look at my brothers doing MMA, sometimes in the gym I also do a jiu-jitsu, you know. And when I look at my brother, I really want to go in the cage to fight, you know.
Yeah.
Mm. So I really got the heart to do it, but it's just in my mind. I gotta have the title.
Yeah.
I gotta have the title.
Right. Yeah. Well, you're big, man. You're like what, 6'1"?
Sorry.
You're 6'1", like you're a big guy for your division.
Big fishing. Yeah, true. So I gotta have to tell it's in here, you know. And if it's in here, I gotta keep on going, you know.
Yeah.
So first I gotta have to title, but I wanna do MMA definitely. Yeah. So and
that'd be interesting.
If some guys are watching, Dana White, if you're watching, I wanna do MMA. So
yeah. All right, man. Awesome.
Do those little gloves entice you? Because I mean, you could probably do a lot of damage with those little gloves compared to like the glory size gloves compared to those MMA gloves.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But that's what I like, you know, because back in the days, I fought with 8 ounce, 10 ounce, but with little gloves, you know. Yeah. And then when I fought Glory, the gloves were getting bigger. So, and I always like to fight with smaller gloves, so the quicker the knockout comes, you know.
Right.
So that's my style. Yeah.
Now, besides training and fighting, what does a predator like to do on his spare time? You have any hobbies that you like to do?
Yeah.
Chasing girls?
I like to do some, I like to do some spending time with my son, you know. This Saturday, he's coming 2 years. So,
Wow.
Yeah, man. I like to spend
terrible
time with
twos.
My son. Sorry?
They're terrible twos. They're like little monsters. They walk around, they want to grab everything.
Yeah, man. Really, but the only thing is, when I'm with him, you know.
Yeah.
At home, I'm gonna show you.
Oh right.
Kitchen. He always. Now we come. He always looking at this.
Ooh, he said,
hey, Daddy. Then he want the gloves.
Oh wow.
Then you wanna go boxing with me, you know?
Yeah, that's awesome.
I gotta show you this one.
Ooh.
The K1. The K1. Nice.
Was that your first one or the second one?
That's my first K1 belt. Okay. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, I won one K1 tournament. I won, so it was the K1.
That was 2012.
Sorry.
That was 2012, right? When you won it in 2012.
Yeah, 2012. Yeah. So I'm spending time with my son, and I also like to do an. I'm doing a little bit vlogging, you know. So nice. It's also nice.
Are you single? Or are you married?
No, I have a girlfriend.
Oh.
And I have a kid with my girlfriend.
Okay, so no chasing girls for you.
No, man. No.
Next time.
No, that time.
Yeah.
<All
right. laughs>
Did you ever use like that, like you're fighting to get girls? Like, hey, I fight. Don't worry, I can protect you.
No, never. But when I was single, you know.
Yeah.
And then when I fought. There was always lots of girls after the fight and stuff like that, you know.
Yeah.
And sometimes but I never did those kind of crazy things. And sometimes when I had a girl, you know, I didn't want them to know that I was a kickboxer.
Oh,
you know?
Wow.
I
don't
know.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
See,
yeah,
if it was me, it'd be the complete opposite. I'll say, hey, I know how to fight. Well, see, with you, you're good looking. You're 6'1". I'm 5'5", man. So I gotta try really hard to get girls going on my end. So.
Oh shit, man.
So plus I'm kind of fat.
What do you do? Kickbox? You do MMA?
Well, like we train like jiu-jitsu. Like we just did some kickbox class with Javier Cordello.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. You did wrestling back in the day too. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. See, with me, I gotta try hard, man. I'm short.
Yeah, you're
short. I have like a gut, like a beer gut. Look at this thing, man. It's not a six pack.
My man.
So.
Yeah, well, he comes over, I feed him well, too, huh?
Yeah. His mom makes me cookies, cake, cheesecake.
I take him over to the parents' house over there. We're all food and drinks.
So I blame this guy and his mom for this beer gut, but it's fine.
The great cookies, huh? I gotta have cookies, man.
Exactly. When we go to my family's house, and my mom just feeds them food all day.
She gives them one serving, she gives them like 10 servings.
Man.
That's why you stick with him, man. You gotta stick with him, man.
Yeah. You won't go hungry.
I starve. It's funny.
Oh, great.
So Like, I'll get into personal. Like, how long have you guys been together? Like, you and your girlfriend. Is it gonna be maybe your wife one day, or just girlfriend?
Put him on the spot.
I don't know. I don't really think about it yet.
You love her. That's all that matters.
Yeah, man, we really don't know.
It's funny.
All right, so what are these last couple of weeks for you in training, man? What are you going to do? Is it, do you kind of tone it down as the fight goes on? Or like at the last week, how do you do it?
2 weeks, so this week and next week, yeah. I'm going full motion. And then the last week, I'm just training sharp, you know.
Yeah.
Watch weight, so I don't have to lose lots of weight because I already did it a little bit with my food.
Okay.
So, yeah, I've been training fitness, you know, to 83 kilo. And now I lost 3 kilo, and I have to lose 3 kilo more, so I'm good.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, and, I'm good.
And like, when do you fly out to Chicago? Are you going to fly out like a week before? Or?
Sorry? Oh, the 20, like a week before, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, cool.
4 days before I'm flying to Chicago.
No, it's cool because, like, I think you fight on the UFC Fight Pass portion of the card.
Yeah,
so
true.
That's kind of cool, man, because it's a big platform for you to compete and have more eyeballs on you.
Yeah.
Does that add more pressure to you, or do you, at this point, like, you don't care about that kind of stuff?
About what?
About the eyeballs, you know, like, knowing that
people are watching.
The fact that you're using Fight Pass, does that bother you at all, or are you kind of used to it by this point?
Listen, I fought big events. I've been around the world.
Yeah.
I don't have that kind of pressure anymore, you know?
That's good.
So, no, that's a way. I fought with Butter on events, you know, and when I fight with Butter on events, you got that pressure also from different kind of people because it's busy.
Yeah.
The dressing room is busy. All those people want something from you because you're with Butter and stuff like this, you know. So I got used to this pressure, you know, because I'm in a gym with lots of champions. So also with Melvin Manuf, you know, I get used to the pressure. So, yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, and you're close with Butter. I mean, he's going through some stuff right now. Is it? Have you spoken to him recently?
No, I didn't spoke to him. He's now in Morocco, so...
Okay.
Yeah. All
right. I wish him the best of luck, yeah.
Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks.
Yeah. So, tell us your prediction. How are you going to... Like, is this fight going to end the decision? Are you going to knock him out? How do you see this fight ending?
I think, you know, and... yeah. I'm just going to be... I'm just going to be cocky. I'm just going to knock the fuck him out.
Oh, I love it. Cocky is good.
Cocky is good. I'm going to
knock him out. Good, man.
I'm going to send the tie back to Thailand.
Yeah, right?
All right. Let the fans know how to find you on, like, Instagram and Facebook and then and your sponsors, too.
You can follow me on... I got my end. You can follow me on Twitter. It's Myrtle G.
Yeah.
You can follow me on Instagram. It is Groenhart 86, Groenhart 86.
Ooh,
sorry.
Fancy.
Instagram, Groenhart 86.
Okay.
And then I got my YouTube channel.
Oh.
It's Murray's Journey.
Yeah, I've seen some of those videos.
Yeah. I got sometimes I'm vlogging a little bit, you know, so I'm putting lots of on my YouTube channel. So Murray's Journey. And what I got more?
And maybe like your sponsors?
And yes, this is my sponsor. Let me see. This is my own brand.
Oh, nice. TGT.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Groene Team. And I got, Max Gym. I got 1401. Label 1401.
If TGT wants to sponsor the MMA Complex, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Hook us up, man. Remember, I'm only 5'5", man. I need it.
We're getting like no TGT tattooed on me or something like that.
Yeah. I'll put it somewhere on my arm, somewhere, man.
You still got place,
yeah,
man.
He's got room.
I got room.
Yeah.
Remember Ace.
And then we got...
Huh?
Then we got GFT and We Deliver. It's also one of my sponsors.
Cool.
And for the rest, I'm still looking for more sponsors. So if you want to sponsor, let me hear something about you.
All right, man. Yeah. Well, looking forward to your fight, and maybe after you win, you can thank the MMA Complex,
and then definitely.
And you can send us a shirt, man, because my 5'5" body needs a brand new shirt, man. So.
I hope I got one for you, man. I saw you got a big belly, man.
I do, man. Yeah,
see? You gotta eat less cookies, man. You gotta eat less
cookies. Man. How about this?
Send us to Amsterdam. Send us cookies to Amsterdam.
Yeah, right? How about this, man? No cookies for 1 week if you send us a shirt. How about that?
deal.
Lose weight to fit into the shirt. Yeah.
Like we do like a handshake, like a virtual handshake on it. There you go, man. All right. All right, brother. Well, thanks for coming on. It was fun chatting with you, man. And safe travels to Chicago. And best of luck on your fight. And remember, don't forget your buddies Josh and James at the MMA Complex.
Thanks, man. You guys are great, man. Thank you for the interview.
All right. Take care, brother.
Take care.
Take care, man. See you guys.
Bye. Bye.